Although making decisions makes computers seem intelligent, looping is what makes computer programs efficient and worthwhile. When you use a loop, you have one set of instructions that operate on over and over again until a condition is met. This means that we can use fewer instructions, and our programs take less time to design and to code, and we can also have fewer errors and a shorter compile time. The basic structure of a while loop begins with the keyword while and is followed by the condition that will be tested. When this condition is true, the statements inside of the while block are going to execute. And once those state conditions change to false, our while loop will exit and we'll continue on with the rest of our program. With a while loop, we have to use a loop control variable, and that is what will control our conditions so that they remain true. Our loop control variable controls the number of times our loop goes through. In a while loop, it's initialized before we enter the loop, then it is tested in our condition, and then the body of the loop has to change the value in some way. After that loop body executes, it will go back up to the condition and test it again. If it's true, it will continue running the statements inside of the loop body, but if it's evaluated to false, it will exit out of the loop and continue on through our program. There are two primary ways that we control the repetitions of a loop. One is through a counter variable, and the other one is through a sentinel value. A counter variable creates a definite counter-controlled loop variable. So this means that we're telling our loop that it is going to only execute 4 times or 15 times. With the sentinel value, we have an indefinite loop, meaning that it will keep running until a condition happens. It's performed a different number of times each time the program executes. It could be based on user input or a value from some other part of our program, but the user will decide how many times the loop executes. Let's take a look at this simple loop. We begin with an integer variable called count, and we initialize it to 0. We start our while loop and we say, well, count is less than 3. We're going to output the word hello, and then we will increase count by 1 and we'll check our condition again. And if that condition is still true, we'll go back through our loop body. But if not, we will exit out and we'll print goodbye. So in this case, on the right-hand side is our output from our simple loop. Count begins at 0. So 0 is less than 3. So we pop into our while loop. We output hello, and then we're adding 1 to count. So count now has the value of 1. We come back up here to our condition. We check to see if count is less than 3. 1 is less than 3. So we continue through here again. We output our second hello, which correlates to this one. We add 1 more to count. So count is now 2. And we come back up here and we check our condition again. 2 is less than 3, so we are continuing back into our loop body. We're going to output again, hello, and the hello displays down here. And we'll increase count by 1, so count will now be 3. And we come back up here, we check our condition. 3 is not less than 3, so this statement turns to false. At this time, we exit out of our while loop, and we come down here and we output goodbye. So here's our sample program run. One way that you can help visualize the different values in count is to actually print out what's inside of your loop control variable. So by adjusting our program just a bit, I've adjusted the output at the same time so that you can see the first time through count is 0, then 1, then 2, and then count turns to 3, and our condition turns to false, and we exit out of our loop and finally print goodbye. Consider this program where it runs based on a user input. This program, we're going to say, how many times do you want to say hello? And we'll grab that value from the user and we'll store it inside a count. We have to adjust our statement just a little bit because we're going to receive a larger number here and we're going to work our way down to 0. Let's say that we receive 3 from the user. 3 is greater than 0, so we'll come down in here and we'll print out hello. We'll take count and we'll subtract 1, so count is now 2. This time we'll come back up here. Check our condition. 2 is still greater than 0. So we'll come back in here, execute what's inside of our while loop again. We'll output hello again. Now we take 2 minus 1, so our loop control variable count is 1. We come back up here, we check our condition again. 1 is greater than 0, so our condition is true. We're popping back down into our while loop. We're outputting hello again. Now we're taking 1 minus 1, which is 0. We come back up here, and 0 is not greater than 0, so we're going to exit out of our while loop and come down here and print goodbye. This program is very flexible. It can be ran however many times the user wants to say hello. So in this example here, the user said that it wants to say hello 9 times. So our loop will run 9 times and then finally exit out and print out goodbye. Our final example here is running until we reach a sentinel value. This program is asking the user to input a name, and when they're finished entering names, they're going to type the word done. So we grab the name from the user, and we say, well, the name doesn't equal done, we are going to output hello plus the name and an exclamation point. Then we're going to prompt the user again to enter another name, remind them when they're finished to type done, and we grab that name again, store it back into our name variable. We come back up here and we do our condition check again. While name does not equal done, we will run our loop again. If name does equal done, we're going to exit out of our loop and output goodbye. Here's a sample run of this program. We ask our user to input a name. When they're finished, type done. This time, type in Bill. So we'll grab Bill, store it into the name variable, and say, hello, Bill. Then we ask them to input another name. This time, they input Tina. Tina does not equal done, so we're going back into our loop body, printing out hello, Tina, asking them to enter another name. And this time, they type in done. At this time, when name doesn't equal done, so name does equal done, so this becomes a false statement, and we exit out of our while loop and we output goodbye. When you're working with while loops, you want to check for the big three. The first item that you want to check for is to make sure that you have a starting value for a variable that will control your loop. This means it will need to be initialized and declared before your loop begins. Inside of our while condition, we're going to test the loop control variable to determine whether the loop body executes. If that condition is true, we're going to execute the loop body, and if it's false, then we're going to exit out of the loop. We also need to remember that in the loop body, we have to alter our loop control variable. If we don't alter our loop control variable, we have an infinite loop, meaning that our condition will never change to false and the loop will never run. So we have to make sure that our loop control variable is changed inside of the loop body as it executes so that our condition will eventually become false and exit out of the loop.